Hello class 4, how are you all? I hope doing well. I have completed the exercises I had given you in lesson 1. So, you see, before I take up this lesson, I'd like to tell you a story from this lesson only. The story is given in the lesson. So, listen to the story carefully. Meena saw her 9-year-old son, Anand, making a painting. She was curious to know who was going to get this piece of art. Her son told her that it was for his classmate's little sister, who was a special child. The entire class was busy making cards, paper chains, caps and masks for her 5th birthday to make her happy. The little girl was unable to walk, speak or hear, but conveyed her happiness by smiling or clapping. Anand's answer was very right and genuine, and that filled Meena's eyes with tears. She could not believe that Anand, who refused to share his toys with his own younger sister, Usha, could be so concerned about bringing joy to a special girl. Meena felt proud of her son. Now, by the story, you came to know about the boy who was painting. He was some art sort of thing he was doing on a piece of paper, and his mother was surprised. Surprised was why? Because she was wondering who he is going to give this piece of art. And then when he replied that this piece of art, he is going to give it to his friend's sister, who was a special child, the entire class was, and he told that the entire class was busy. They were all making cards, paper chains, caps and mask for her 5th birthday to make her happy. That child was a special child. What do you understand by special child? Special, you might say that someone who is very important is a special person. Here, special is referred to something. Why? Because that child was not a normal child like all of us. She could not talk. Why? You see, in the, towards the end of the story, it is said that she conveyed her happiness. When she felt happy, she conveyed her happiness by clapping and smiling. That means she could not tell, could not speak. Either she could not hear also, or there was some sort of problem with her that she could not grow properly. So such type of children are called special children, because special care is taken for such type of children. So Anand's answer, what he gave, the reply, that filled the mother's eyes with tears. Why? Because Anand used to never share his things with his own sister. Many of you all also do it. Your things you don't like to give to your sister. You want to keep that toy. No, this is mine. I will play. Why? I will give to you. I won't give. Your sister might say, this is mine. I won't give you. So, such type of fights keep taking place. And Anand was ready to help this special girl. And the entire class, the whole class was doing it. So this sort of concern when we have for others, this sort of soft nature we have for others, when we have such feelings for such people or someone who is really needing a lot of care from us, when we have this type of attitude, we call it sensitiveness. The lesson is all about this only, sensitivity towards others, being caring, being concerned, being helpful towards others. This is all about the lesson. You see, we are living where? In a society. What is a society? A society is a group of people living in the same area, in different houses, the families are living, but in an organized way. And today we are educated, we are civilized, means in one way we can say that now we are not living like how the early man used to live. And that's why we are called organized group of people. So I'll just wait for a while and again take up the lesson. So have a good day, Jasang, and listen to the video carefully before listening to the next one. So I'm stopping.